How did you start and why did you start cooking on geothermal stream?
That's a very strange story, what I'm going to tell you now, because in restaurants environment there's always a competition.
Uh-huh.
And always was it like this: if I make a special menu, somebody else do my same menu 2 weeks later, you know?
Uh-huh.
So I said to my wife, I have to come with something unique, something special.
Uh-huh.
So one night I had a dream about this kitchen outside. So I woke up 4 o'clock in the morning and I said to my wife, I have to build a geothermal kitchen outside. I dreamed it all and I know exactly what I should do. She said, take your pill and go to sleep.
Yeah.
You're getting crazy, she said to me. So no, I have to do it. I was like,
next day you woke up?
Yeah, next day I woke up, I start building this.
Yeah.
It took me 2 weeks to do it all, and it worked from the first day, mm-hmm. actually. So first I only use it to bake bread, then I start baking a fine cake, like a sponge cake, chocolate cake, carrot cake, uh-huh. and nice cakes. And then I start use it for making a good food. So I learned to work with the geothermal, you can get a better cooking. Why is that? This is because we have a heat up to 170 Celsius hot, mm-hmm. and 14 kilobar steam pressure.
Uh-huh.
So basically you're cooking in the hot air.
Yeah.
So when you put like a 1 kilo of meat there, you will get back 1 kilo plus.
Uh-huh.
Because when the normal oven will dry up the meat.
Mm-hmm.
But this do not. So we have to change the business into a some special restaurant and something special, something unique.
Uh-huh.
We trying to be very good learner to learn on this power. Mm-hmm. So we put a pipe in the kitchen and we have an oven and pots running by the geothermal there also. And now we are baking bread for Icelandic Airlines. They use it on the Sarah Club for the special menu, Icelandic menu there.
Mm-hmm.
Also, we are making 5 different types of geothermal bread. People like to buy, take it with them home, you know. And delicate cake we have also.
Place special in terms of geothermal energy?
Yeah.
How deep do you have to...
Drink down. We are so lucky. You see the geothermal park is here.
Uh-huh.
Over there you see the fan there? So the park is there. Then over there you have a very nice geothermal exhibition area there. You can go and see it all.
Yeah.
And they gave me license to plug into there. We just open up like this.
Oh, okay.
And you get a boiling water.
Oh.
Right away.
Instantly.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
This is a green power.
This is the maximum temperature that you can get.
170.
Uh-huh.
So this is very strong heat. But like I said before, the pressure is very important. It's not good to have a high heat, low pressure, because there's a lot of water coming in.
Mm-hmm.
But also we have changed the oven, used to be electricity oven. Yeah. We had changed into only steam oven, using this steam. So we have two ovens here. One used to spend 35 kilowatts, but now it's spending zero.
Yeah.
But working beautifully on the geothermal power. We are baking in this oven a chocolate cake.
Uh-huh.
So you can see it when I take it out. Very nice chocolate cake.
Looks wonderful.
Yeah, so this is cooked by the geothermal. And
so you already patented?
No.
Recipe?
No.
How many restaurants that are cooking on geothermal steam are working in Iceland? You are the only one.
I'm the only one in the world.
You are the only one in the world?
Yeah.
Okay. Really?
Yeah. If you Google it up, it's the only one. This is
yeah, because I Google
yeah.
in the search engine and
yeah.
it was my first result.
Yeah.